Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capilan Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Guys, today what I'm going to do is to try to modify my first experiment. That was the turning on of the LED. Okay. Now, guys, today what I'm going to do is to show you the modification that I have done in my project. Okay, now actually what I did is to add a small, I have here my this is my push button switch. Okay, so this is a push button switch. Now actually if I will turn it on, it will try to lit the LED. Okay, so that is the modification I have done here. Now guys, I am doing this experiment number 2 to give you an idea, because the problem, if you will not be very careful in building your circuit, there is a possibility that you will fry your RPI. Okay, so you might damage your Raspberry Pi. So how this one will happen? Okay, now as you can see, I have here my this is my push button switch. Okay, now one leg is connected to my, that is 3.3 volts. Okay, as you can see, I have here the 3.3 volts. Okay, now I have also the ground line there. Okay, now one leg of my, one leg of this push button switch is connected to 3.3 volts. Then the other leg is connected to my GPIO number 23. Okay, so meaning this GPIO number 23, I have to configure this pin as an input. Okay, now if you remember, in Arduino we are also configuring the pin if it is input or output. Now what I'm trying to say here, if you accidentally configure your GPIO 23 as an output, there's a possibility that you will damage your RPI, because if this pin is accidentally configured as an output, the pin will release a 3.3 volts, then the 3.3 volts will be connected to the ground. Okay, now to prevent that damage, we are using this one. Okay, so let me see if you can see. Now this one is a current limiting resistor, so this one will act like a load. Okay, so to prevent direct short of 3.3 volts when you configure your GPIO 23 as an output, because this one, the GPIO 23, that pin is already, it's also connected to the ground. As you can see, I had tried to put here one current limiting resistor so that it will serve as a load. So my 3.3 volts will not go directly to the ground, because I have connection in my RPI to the ground. So that is one of the caution that you need to take care, especially if you are building your circuit. Okay, so this time, as I said, I already prepared the, so I will try to turn it on. As you can see, my LED lit up. Okay, now actually in the first experiment, my GPIO number 4 will be the one to drive the LED. Okay, so here, by putting additional push button switch, we are simulating to this one can be used if you are going to develop home automation using this Raspberry Pi. So this one is like you have a let's say this LED is a motor in your home. So this push button switch will act like a manual testing of your motor. So when you push the switch, then your motor will run. So it's just like running your motor in manual. Of course, if you have a motor, there will always be a motor control. Okay, so in your motor control, you will be having a selector switch, that when you put it in manual, then you can push this push button, then it will turn on manually your equipment. Okay, so that's why I'm doing this, just to give you an idea how are you going to create a simple control for an equipment in your house. Okay, now let me show you the program. Okay, now actually I already written the program, that's why you see it is already working. Okay, now this time I want to show you the program itself. Okay, now let me walk you through with the program. Okay, so let me just focus you in my, okay, now the problem is my window is being reflected in my screen. Okay, anyway, I think it's still readable. Now actually the first line here is to import the input device. Now guys, this input device is the object, like this will be the one that will configure, that this will be the one that you will use to configure your GPIO or your switch as an input device. Okay, so from GPIO 0 import input device, then likewise from time you import the sleep to, so we can use some time delay, then GPIO 0 import LED. Now this is the LED that we use in our first experiment. Now LED, now I'm declaring a variable here, LED is equals to LED. Now I'm using now the imported, we can say this is the object, then I'm pointing my LED to GPIO number 4. Okay, now switch, so I declared a variable here, switch, then I'm using now the imported object here, the input device, then I'm pointing this switch to GPIO number 23. Okay, now the next part, line number 7, is to use repetition structure. Okay, so while it is true, then sleep, put some time delay, half a second, then test the value of the switch, this variable switch that value, so we are just calling the function or the method that value is equals true. If the switch is pushed, then we will be having a true or one value there, then we will say turn on the LED. okay, so we are calling now the object LED. okay, then that on method. Okay, now else, if it is not pushed, then it should be off. Okay, so this is a very simple program in turning on an LED using a push button switch. Okay, so let me show you again the project. Okay, turn on. Okay, turn on. Okay, so guys, this is a simple project wherein you can use in using in controlling one of the motors or equipment in your home or in your house. Okay, so guys, thank you very much for watching this simple tutorial. If you are new to my channel, please help me in promoting my channel by subscribing, and you can always click the notification bell so that you will be notified for new tutorials. Now again, Santos Capilian Jr. will always end my video tutorial in saying God bless us all, let's all be safe, and bye for now.